Hey everyone, it's Megan. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to walk you through the steps that I took to prepare for Bealtaine or Beltane. And I hope you have fun and get some new ideas maybe, or just enjoy this little vlog style. It's not really a vlog. Enjoy all of these clips that I just decided to throw together for a Beltane video while I prepared. So what you get to see today is me and my daughter digging our fire pit. We're gonna make some creamsicles, and I have a recipe for that that is vegan and gluten-free. I also decided to make some flower crowns, but in true Megan fashion. And then we're gonna end it with our lighting of our fire and just talking a little bit about what I believe and why I celebrate Bealtaine the way that I do. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna go find a place for my temporary fire pit. I've never really been in a position where I could have my own fire pit. During the holidays anyway. Last Beltane, I was preparing to move here to Florida. Honestly, prior to that, it was apartments and living with other people and just no real room, I guess, to have my own fire pit. So I'm gonna go dig a temporary fire pit. It's gonna be temporary because our pool is gonna end up going there, and then I will be able to find a place for a more permanent one. But I want to bring you along as I dig my fire pit, and let's talk about why fire is important on Beltane or Bealtaine. So I'm not really looking for anything in particular when it comes to where I'm going to put my fire pit. Oh, come outside. Come on. Come on. Basically, it just needs to stay away from the irrigation system and away from any trees. That tree and then this massive tree behind me needs to stay away from the trees. So I'm probably gonna put it probably right about here, right where I'm standing. What are you doing? What are you doing? Bealtaine is one of four Celtic fire festivals, and fire plays an important role in the celebrations of Bealtaine even today. Traditionally, bonfires would be lit and cattle would be driven between them while the smoke warded off negative spirits, sickness, and disease for the coming summer months. This is going to be the first year I will have a bonfire of my own for Bealtaine. It has never failed in the past that I was either never able to, or something else just got in the way. This year though, I have a house of my own, a backyard, and room for a fire. Bealtaine marks the beginning of summer for me. In my part of Florida, we're already starting to feel the sting of summer sun if we stay outside too long. The humidity is creeping in too, leaving us sticky, sweaty, and glistening if we spend enough time outside. Spiritually, this is a time of liminality. We know that the misty veil between our world and the other world is thin during Samhain, but it also begins to thin around Bealtaine too. Communication with the other world, spirits, and our gods is easier now as the mists begin to part. I like to welcome summer, even if it is obscenely hot on some days. Give thanks to the glowing star that gives our planet life, stand toward it, light your fires in its honor, and dance in the coming warmth. Bealtaine is traditionally a time of weddings, hand fastings, and general adult frivolity. Flowers are in bloom and life is growing all around us. In some parts of the world, this is a time when the ground is just finally starting to soften enough to let greenery shoot up from the soil. Flower crowns are a popular craft to do on Bealtaine and midsummer. But instead of creating a flower crown with real flowers, I decided to crochet one. It didn't turn out exactly as I wanted, but that's okay. And it never fails that my daughter's is always better than mine, even though I make both of them. Since it's getting warmer and we're going to be spending more time outside, what better way to celebrate summer than with homemade popsicles? I came up with this recipe one day because I wanted something tasty without the dairy. These tropical creamsicles are delicious, plant-based alternatives to creamsicles that you can buy in the store. Plus, they're pretty tasty too. I wanted to include fruit that reminds me of summer, and what better fruit than a pineapple and mango? For me anyway, those fruits bring to mind warm summer days, probably because they remind me of the beach. Anyway, for this recipe, you're going to need a blender, one can of unsweetened coconut cream, 2 cups of frozen fruit. I used this blend from the grocery store, but if pineapples and mangoes aren't your thing, substitute with your favorite frozen fruit. Then add everything to the blender and put about 2 tablespoons of agave syrup. I say about because I don't measure it. Again, a substitute with your sweetener of choice. You can even use honey or maple syrup. Then you're going to blend it all together in a blender, pour it in your popsicle mold, and let it freeze. Then enjoy them after your Bealtaine dinner by the fire, or whenever you get hot.
No, I took away from the eye!
It's time to light our Bealtaine fire. As the fire catches and begins to burn, I'm thinking of the ways my life has changed over the years. Liminal times of the year will do that for me, and these seasonal transitions are no different. As we enjoy our creamsicles, I take some time to write down my hopes and wishes for the summer, things I want to accomplish before Samhain, and things I need to let go of. I'll burn a special bundle of herbs as an offering to Bridget for being with me and helping me walk this path. Then I'll take a leap of faith and hop over the fire. My Bealtaine celebrations don't always look like everyone else's, and that's okay because I'm working within the confines of what I have. I have space for a fire, so I'm lighting a fire. It's really hot, so I'm gonna make creamsicles and enjoy the fruit that I have available to me. But along the spiritual side, Bealtaine is a liminal time for me. And some things that you didn't see in this video include conversations with my gods, guides, and ancestors, divination that I have done, and some heavy deity work that I've really been thinking about. But those things are all very personal to me, and I am not going to share them here. However you celebrate, I really hope that you have an amazing May Day, Beltane, Bealtaine, whatever you're celebrating right now or within this time. If you don't celebrate anything, I just hope you have a fantastic day and welcome in either summer or fall, wherever you are. Thank you so much for watching and for being here with me for this little peek into how I celebrate my Sabbats. I don't do a lot of big rituals. What I do is mainly focused on folk stuff and things that I do at home. My connection with the divine and the world around me is personal and not one that I feel called to ritualize. If you're looking for community, you can join me over on Discord or in my Facebook group. Find me on all of my social media, and if you'd like to help support the show, check the links in the description below. You can support the show on Patreon for as little as $1 a month and get exclusive perks and content, or you can just buy me a coffee. Thank you so much to all of my current patrons, all of my past patrons, and all of my future patrons. Be sure to check out my website and my shop as well. So again, have a wonderful day, a wonderful week, a wonderful whenever it is that you're watching this, and I'll see you in my next video.